Having too much belly fat can lead to different health conditions like diabetes and heart disease, but this belly fat can be reduced through specific types of exercise training. I'm going to walk you through different types of fat, different types of exercise training that's used to target belly fat, and the top two exercises for getting rid of that belly fat. I'm Dr. Elise Brown. I'm a scientist who studies how exercise helps to prevent and slow the progression of diabetes. Belly fat includes several different types of fat based on their location. We've got subcutaneous fat, which is the fat that's found directly underneath the skin. We've got visceral fat, which is the fat that's found around our organs, like our liver and our heart. And then we have ectopic fat, which is fat that gets stored within our organs. In obesity, most fat tends to accumulate around the belly or the hips. Higher amounts of visceral fat and ectopic fat, this is linked to increased risk for developing heart disease and diabetes. Now, exercise is a great way to reduce all three types of fat, and intensity matters when it comes to getting rid of belly fat. How much energy we expend or the amount of calories burned, it's going to depend on how long the exercise session is, what type of exercise that we're doing, and the intensity of that exercise. When we experience weight loss from exercise, we tend to lose more visceral fat relative to subcutaneous fat. And that's great news for our metabolic health. There was a 2024 meta-analysis of 84 randomized controlled trials that looked at how different types of exercise impacted visceral fat in people who were classified as either overweight or obese, and it included just under 5,000 participants. They looked at continuous, moderate, and high-intensity cardio, they looked at strength training, and they also looked at high-intensity interval training, or HIIT. All of these different exercise types reduce subcutaneous fat and visceral fat, but the type of exercise that reduced the most fat were HIIT and high-intensity cardio. High-intensity cardio means that your heart rate is above 75% of max heart rate while doing some type of continuous aerobic exercise like riding a bike or going for a run. The easiest way to calculate your max heart rate is by subtracting your age from 220. For someone who's 50 years old, they would subtract 50 from 220 and end up with an estimated max heart rate of 170 beats per minute. Multiply 170 by 0.75, which is 75%, and you get 127.5 beats per minute, rounded up to 128 beats per minute. So essentially, somebody that's 50 years old, they would need to be exercising with their heart rate at least 128 beats per minute. If you want to do a little more math for a more accurate estimated max heart rate, use the Tanaka formula. Multiply your age by 0.7 and then subtract this value from 208. For that same 50-year-old, we would multiply 50 by 0.7, which gives us 35, and then subtract 35 from 208, resulting in a max heart rate of 173 beats per minute. Still pretty close to the 220 minus age method. HIIT uses that same heart rate criteria of at least 75% of max heart rate, but the aerobic exercise is essentially repeated bouts of high intensity work alternated with recovery periods, and the recovery periods are typically either rest or low intensity activity. Since HIIT involves recovery periods, the potential is greater for reaching higher intensities compared to doing continuous high intensity cardio. You can even reach intensities over 90% of max heart rate, and that's considered sprint interval training. If you're liking this video so far, take a look at my exercise education playlist down in the description. So what is it about high intensity exercise that makes it so good at attacking belly fat? Well, what we see with high intensity, but not moderate intensity cardio, is we see the body secretion of interleukin 6, myokines, and irisin. These are proteins related to inflammation and tissue repair. Irisin in particular helps to convert white adipose tissue, which stores fat, into beige adipose tissue, which burns fat. Other reasons that HIIT is better than moderate intensity cardio at burning belly fat is that HIIT is better at raising metabolism, specifically after we exercise. It's also better at lowering insulin and triglycerides after a meal, and it's also better at burning more fat when we first wake up in the morning. So what are the best exercises to incorporate into your HIIT or your high-intensity cardio program? Well, according to a meta-analysis by Maylard and colleagues, they found that running is the number one exercise for burning total body fat and visceral fat, and biking is number two. Some of the reasons that more fat is burned with running compared to biking is because there's greater muscle activation in running, metabolism is increased more after running compared to biking, and also more fat is lost when doing running compared to biking at the same intensity. Specific to visceral fat, this type of fat has more beta adrenergic receptors than subcutaneous fat, and these receptors play a key role in the breakdown of fat. HIIT running activates more catecholamines or stress hormones, which tend to favor burning fat with beta adrenergic receptors. Now, the options of running versus biking, they're a bit biased. And I say that because in the majority of exercise science labs, the two most common pieces of aerobic testing equipment are treadmills and bikes. Now, if you're thinking about how you're going to incorporate this type of training into your routine, if we go back to that meta-analysis I was talking about earlier, the majority of the studies that were included, the protocols were 4 minutes of high-intensity work, followed by 3 minutes of recovery. And the majority of those recovery periods were light intensity activity. Most of the exercise sessions were between 20 to 30 minutes long. The majority of the interventions were 3 times a week, and most of them were 12 weeks long. It's best to start HIIT after you've already developed a base fitness level, like doing between 20 to 60 minutes of exercise 3 to 5 times a week. And if you have diabetes, heart disease, or any other type of health condition, please consult with your physician before making any type of lifestyle changes, especially high intensity exercise. Thank you for watching.